Hi there. Whenever I talk about birds in flight, people always say, but what are the settings? And that very much depends. How fast the bird's moving, how fast it's beating its wings, all sorts of things. But at the end of the day, if you're not getting a sharp photo, up the shutter speed. What I'm here to talk to you about today is what you're doing wrong. And when I talk about you, I mean you and your body. How you use your body translates to the photo, and whether you're likely to keep the bird in the frame as you're tracking it in flight. So let's explore that for the three common situations where I'm photographing birds in flight: handheld, using a gimbal head, and lying down. So let's get on with it. Today I'm at a seabird colony, and all the techniques that I show you will help you keep the bird in the frame whilst you're tracking it in flight, giving your camera a much better chance of focusing on it. And of course, I'll show you the photos I got along the way. So let's start with handheld, and the big mistake that I see lots of people doing is panning using their neck. So what you can do here is a little experiment which will show you the problem with panning using your neck. So if you've got your camera up like this, tracking a bird across the sky, and you move with your neck, what happens is that you get an arc type motion. So just look at something in the distance and turn your head one way and then back and the other way and back. And what you'll see is your head starts here and moves gradually down, and starts here and moves gradually down that side. And so it's very difficult trying to keep the bird in the frame when your neck isn't moving horizontally. So that is the natural thing to do. But if you now try to keep your eyes level, so concentrate as you turn your head on keeping your eyes perfectly level, what you'll find, you get to about here and you get a strain on your neck. So your body naturally doesn't want to move that way. It wants to move your head in an arc. So a much better way is to turn from the waist. Now, in order to make that work, we need to think about our stance. So the best way to do it is with an L stance. So you want your dominant foot at the back and your less dominant foot at right angles, making an L shape. And that way you can pan and move your waist and keep the line perfectly level, which gives you a much better chance of keeping the bird in the frame as you pan across the sky. And also, to make this work, you want to think about your elbows. So if you've got your elbows out here, they're not very stable. They're liable to move around, which gives you some up and down motion as you're panning with the bird. So what you really want is your elbows in close to your body. In reality, with these long lenses, what you probably find is that your right elbow is to the side of your body and your left elbow is slightly tucked into your belly. So you've got a stance that's something like this. And that way you've got a nice steady motion as you move left to right. So as with anything that requires a physical technique, this takes a little bit of getting used to. It takes a little bit of practice, in the same way that a sports person would concentrate on their stance, on their technique. You need to concentrate on yours too. And I guarantee you, if you don't do this method, go out there, spend a couple of hours practicing, and you will end up with more birds in the frame when you're tracking them in flight. Thank you. So there are lots of good reasons to photograph birds lying down. So it might be that you're photographing birds flying along the clifftop, diving from the clifftop, photographing them flying over a pond or a river, something like that. And the number one mistake I see people make is to put their camera down on the tripod foot, look through the screen at the back, and turn their camera with it. Now, you're never going to turn the camera as smoothly and easily as you are like that. It's fine doing this for a non-moving shot, a portrait shot of a bird, but when they're moving, you need to be able to move the camera smoother. So in this situation, what you want to do is turn your body into a tripod or a monopod. We'll come to that in a moment. So you need three points of contact. So one elbow on the ground, two elbows on the ground, tripod in hand, and the third point of contact is your eye. And you've made three triangles there and effectively turned your body into a tripod. Now, if the bird's not flying particularly far, or you don't need to pan particularly far, this is a perfect technique because you don't need to move your neck too much. But if you need to move your neck a little bit more, you will get the issue we talked about earlier where your neck arcs. So in that situation, you want to turn your body into a monopod. So one elbow on the ground, camera in hand, and use your elbow as the pivot, and that allows you to get a nice smooth motion as you turn. So you can create a tripod or a monopod from your body. So I love shooting with a gimbal head, and it doesn't matter if you're standing, kneeling, got the gimbal head mounted on a shelf in a hide, anywhere that you can mount a gimbal head, it gives you really smooth motion. Now it does take a bit of getting used to if you're not used to using it and you mainly shoot handheld, but you will get much smoother motion by using this. But the number one mistake I see that people make is that they turn from the camera. And also, not only that they turn from the camera, they look through the LCD screen as they do it. So if I loosen this off, what they do is they'll pan like this, and you just don't end up with quite as smooth motion as you could do because your hand is pushing the camera around. Now, we're very used to moving our hands to move the camera to get in position. But I've got a technique to show to you that will help you track the bird really well using a gimbal head. So the first thing is make sure that your gimbal head is properly balanced. And if it isn't, you can check out my video on how to balance a gimbal head. And I'll link that above and in the description below. But once you've got your gimbal perfectly balanced, you want to have one hand on the camera to press the shutter, move any other knobs, buttons, etc. that you need. And the other hand over the front of the camera as a counterweight, and you use your front hand to move. So just allow your back hand to move with it. And this is what takes a little bit of getting used to. But if you use your knuckles, and imagine that there's a line that runs from that ridge of your knuckles onto infinity, and have those knuckles on the top of the camera. And then as you're panning with it, imagine that that line from your knuckles extends out to the bird. And all you want to do is get that line to keep pace with the bird. So as you're moving, that line keeps pace with the bird and it helps you move at exactly the right pace and get that smooth motion. So practice using that technique if you've got a gimbal head. I promise you, after a short while, you'll find it so effective and you'll barely ever have the bird going outside of the frame. So could you be the reason why the bird goes outside the frame and then you miss the shot? It's important to think about the physiology of it all and how you use your body to its best abilities to help your camera. Settings won't do everything. Another important aspect of photographing birds in flight is to think about the background and the context that you give the bird. And I made a video at this same place last year on that topic, which you can see here. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.